You see more and more young people, like 20 years old, 30 years old, they are started to get diagnosed that they have cholesterol, diabetes, hypertension, and some of them are taking medicine already. Yeah, pre-diabetic, that's very, very common. So even for young children, infants, they also have like asthma, allergies problem, like since they are born. So why is it actually, what is actually happening nowadays? And because, and starting from that age when they got diagnosed, it's just like their whole life is forever with medications, things like that already. So that's why we talk about they died, they have died too long. Their quality of life is not there already. So that's why we want to like, today we're going to touch more on nutrition part to help all of you to live longer. Okay. So
yeah, not only anyone, live longer, yeah. Have to be live healthy also.
Healthy. Yeah. And yeah. With good quality of life. That's very important. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. So do you have know anyone who has all
having
these issues?
This yeah. issue, yeah. Usually I can see a lot of youngsters start to have like gastric problem. And instead, at their age, maybe age of teenager or 20 plus, they should have a very fit feature, you know. But instead, nowadays, we can see a lot of obesity amongst the children and the teenager as well. And also a lot of kids low in immune system. So that's why you see during this pandemic, a lot of kids get infected as well because of low immune system. And you can also see as a teenager and those working adult, 20 plus, supposedly your texture should be very nice texture, but a lot of people start to have a lot of pimples or maybe freckles kind of things. What happened? Yeah, can we go to the next slide, Chihua? And you can see a lot of people also start to have dry hair, hair loss, migraine issue, like what I experienced during my 20 plus, during my working out, working time, the time working life. So I used to have migraine as well. That time is 20 plus or more, you know. That time is still considered the peak of a person's life, you know, 25 to 26, that age actually should be peak and it should be very good in stamina. But yet, a lot of people are having this kind of problem like eye bags, dark circles, bleeding gums, and also have a type B diabetics issue. You can easily can see people, the children with around 19 years or 20, like my father's friend, his son, when he went to Australia for further studies that time, he need to bring a lot of high cholesterol medication with him. Just imagine, just only 19 or 19, 20, you know. So he need to take the medication for how long? So until he died. So this is what we worry about that. You can see, do you notice that a lot of people around you have this kind of issue? If yes, do share with him and do share with what we share tonight with him and bring him to your friends, to us, okay? We will help to solve their issue, okay? Next.
Okay, why is it like there are so many things, so many symptoms that all those discomfort that we showed just now. So all this is not like actually can kill you instantly, but it's going to stay there to annoy you for a very, very long period of time, right? So one of the reasons is because of this hidden hunger thingy. Okay, hidden hunger means it's a hunger at a cellular level, means your cell is not getting enough nutrition, okay? Or is getting excessive of certain nutrients but lacking in other nutrients. For example, maybe you are taking a lot of carbohydrates, but then you are not taking enough of like vitamin C, vitamin A, things like that. So it causes your cell to feel that like I'm still not getting full nutrition that I need. Okay, so yeah. That's why studies have shown that 70% of chronic diseases means long-term diseases like diabetes, cardiovascular, heart problems, stroke, cancer, all these are all related to hidden hunger, okay?
Yeah.
So, for example, do you know that when we use electronic devices like phone, laptops, iPad, and even the 那个网红灯, what is it called? The ring light, okay? It also speeds up the usage of vitamin A in our body, okay? Do you know that nowadays, if you are using your eyes for very long hours facing all these devices, you need to take 0.5 to 1 kg of carrots a day. Okay, that's a lot.
That's okay? A lot.
It's really a lot. Okay, and for people who play games, computer games, for even longer hours, they need 1.5 to 2.5 kg of carrots a day. Okay.
That is only for one person, you know. Yeah, I used to blend the carrot juice for the whole family, 2 kg for the whole family. But this one is for one person. That means it's not enough. So I need to top up some more.
Rabbits don't eat that much. It's because rabbits don't play games. They don't use phone. Okay. So every day they see the greens. Okay. So for us, right, it's like one whole family, probably just one batang of carrot a day, right? Yes. So how is it going to be sufficient for people, different people? And I believe nowadays, whole family are using phones, right? Okay. So if, for example, if you don't like to eat carrots, okay, other source of vitamin A, you can take peaches. Okay. You need to eat 52 peaches a day. Okay. So why is it so much? Okay. One of the things is because when we are using electronic devices, we use up super fast. Second thing is that the quality of our food are degrading. Okay. That's why it caused the nutritional level to start to drop. That's why that we need to eat even more of the foods nowadays. Okay. Right. So that's why you see that nutrients are very essential in prevention of chronic diseases. This is already a fact, already proven by studies and research. So we all know about this, but then what are we currently doing for ourselves? Yeah. Right.
You know what is the difference between chronic and acute? Acute is means it can kill immediately, but chronic, it won't kill you immediately, but it will take long term to affect your life. So that one is called chronic. Something like if you got heart attack, that one is acute. That means it will cause you die immediately. But chronic means you may have like high blood pressure, but it won't kill immediately. But eventually, it will take time to affect your lifestyle, your health,
your other organs,
organs as well. Yeah, for a long period of time, then only you die. That is called chronic. Okay, so you see, what you used to eat now we know, we need to eat healthy. But when you go outside, so these are the food that you have to choose from. So which one you think is good for you? We hardly. So that's why we say, we cannot blame someone, but we have to say
because Malaysian is food of heaven.
Yes, heaven of food. Yeah, the whole market is this kind of food. So you have no choice. You have to choose the best from the worst. This is what we have to do. Okay. So is there any other places, any other way? Very hard. You see, I used to take this kind of breakfast, during my working time. So when I 20 plus at time after graduated from the university, when I start to work. So morning, I also have maybe like kong lo min la, or maybe like this la, the kway teow soup, or maybe curry noodles in the morning. But afternoon, I will have almost the same. Nighttime, because we are single at that time, right? So we don't cook. So we used to take almost the same thing, just only like change different type of noodles only and change different kind of soup only. So what is the feature of this? It's very economical, easy. So we eat, we order, sit down, maybe within 1 hour time, we can complete everything already. So it's delicious also and filling. But do you know that the nutrient is very low? Then the fiber in all this kind of food is low and oily as well. And a lot of flavoring, a lot of ajinomoto. So that's why the nutrients content is very low. So this kind of food actually can make you feel full, but your cell won't get full. I mean, your cell is still hungry. Your stomach not hungry, but your cell is hungry because your cell never get the right nutrient from this kind of food. So slowly you will start to build out certain diseases, or your body will give you some signal which you are not aware of. Probably later on, we will share more, then you will notice, you will know more why we have to eat more nutritious food than those simple food. Because a good breakfast or good and ideal breakfast should have content of 40 types of nutrients and easy to digest and also not so heavy. Why we say not so heavy? If possible, try to have less sugar, less oil, and less salt or even no salt, preferably for a breakfast. Okay, next. So why we say breakfast is so important? Actually, if you really look at these words, breakfast, actually is break the fast. So when you say break the fast, just imagine, usually you will have your dinner around maybe 6 or 7, the latest by 8 o'clock. So early in the morning, you've been fasting for almost like 10 to 12 hours already. So early in the morning, your stomach is so empty, it's just like a sponge. The sponge is so clean and so light. So at this hour, this, this time, the first meal of the day, if you eat right, actually the whole day, you will have a very good stamina. But if you eat wrong, you will feel that your energy level can go up very fast, but go down very fast as well. And then the whole day, your mood will swing also. Not only your mood swing, but your energy will swing as well. So the first meal of the day, you must choose the right meal. Okay, next. Okay, a breakfast we should eat like a king, and the lunch should eat like normal, just acceptable. It's just equal, balance will do already. But breakfast has to be very heavy because it will determine the whole day energy in your breakfast. Just imagine early in the morning, like a car, if the car no fuel, do you think the car can move? Cannot move, right? But how come our body early in the morning, we never take anything, but we can still moving around. We can still do a lot of things, driving, do our work, because our body actually will store some nutrients and store some energy inside ourselves. So if you never eat anything, our body actually will start to retrieve and start to steal the nutrient from yourself. Eventually, your body will start to have deficit in the nutrient and energy, then will start to build up some diseases already. But a lot of people didn't know about this thing. They start to skip breakfast or not eating a good breakfast. Instead, they eat very heavy dinner. So that's why you can see nowadays a lot of people getting obese because of wrong. Because dinner, if you eat it so heavy, but you never have any activity at the end, then you will sleep after 2 or 3 hours. So all the energy store where? Store in your belly, so you will get fatter and fatter. But in the morning, if you eat heavy, you'll use up the energy up to the day. So it won't cause you any obesity if you eat heavy breakfast. Okay?
Yeah, next. You're able to burn off the breakfast
energy. And, yeah. Yes. Okay? So there's a research to take 3 group of kids to observe their meal, observe their diet and activity. So this researcher tried to check. They take 3 group of children. One group is with very nutritious and heavy breakfast. The other one is just to take a normal breakfast. And another group is just without any breakfast. So they found out that those kids with very heavy and nutritious breakfast, actually they can perform better. Their learning is faster. Their social ability is much better. And also their response, and then they respond to any unexpected situation. Their response is much better, fast in response. And then also their learning ability, and then they are more optimistic compared to the other group of children. So you can see how important is the breakfast, okay, for everyone. So next to Qihua already.
Yeah, so you know, our health, this is the 4 pillars of health. We actually need to earn the health ourselves. So it's E-A-R-N. E is exercise. We need to do certain level of activity every day. A is attitude, means you need to stay happy, stay positive about everything that's happening around you. Then R is rest, getting good quality sleep, good quality rest. And N is nutrition, we need to eat healthy. So do you know that, which one do you think is the one that you can do the best? E-A-R-O-N. Type. Okay, so to me, it's like nutrition is the easiest for me because exercise, I'm not so into exercise.
Okay? Me too.
So attitude is sometimes it really depends on what's happening on that day. And rest sometimes because whenever you are stressed, whenever you are in a bad mood, whenever you're in a bad mood and it's really hard to fall asleep. But then I just want to tell you that nutrition is able to help on E, A, and R if you have done it right. Okay?
Yes.
So these are all the nutrients that we need in a day. It's separated into macronutrients and micronutrients, okay, and also water as well. Okay, so all this is very important. So in total, there are about 40 types of nutrients that our body needs, our cell needs every day. Okay, so sometimes it's like you don't even know what is it, but then your body needs it, right? So do you know what is chromium?
Yeah.
What is chromium? Have you eaten chromium today?
You can't control because this is what your DNA determines. Your DNA actually already tell you need all these 40 yes. types of nutrients in your cell. So you yeah. cannot tell the tell your DNA, no, this one I don't need. I just take it away. No way. This is determined by your own DNA. Okay?
Yeah. So exactly what is PAPA? So PAPA is one of the B complex. Okay. So I'm just going to explain each and everything, of course, not everything. So first of all, protein. Protein is super, super important. It's the basic building blocks of life. Without protein, there's no you. Okay. So it's used for building all the cells, renew, repair. It's helped in brain development in children, especially. So if during that period of time, like third month of pregnancy and first year of life, the mother is not feeding them with enough protein is going to affect their brain development. Okay, so it protein also helps in building up our immune cells, our white blood cells, our antibody to fight infections. So that's why even like during COVID time, protein becomes so important apart from vitamin C. Okay, so and collagen basically 70% of our body is made from collagen from your blood vessel, your skin, hair, nail, bones, muscle, joints. So do you know that if you are lacking of protein, lacking of collagen, it actually will cause you to have high blood pressure as well. Okay. So it's really not just your skin is sagging, you will get high blood pressure as well. So that's very, very important. And for transportation in our body, like oxygen, your fats, neurotransmitter is the how our nerve communicate with each other. There's a transport between them. So neurotransmitter is made from protein as well. So if you are lacking of protein, how is your nerve going to function? That's going to affect as well. So it helps to maintain blood pressure and your blood pH, helps in producing hormone, enzyme. All these are helps in all the processes in our body, like converting your food into energy, converting what you eat, into break down what you eat into something that's absorbed by your body. All this is so very important in our body functions and helps in wound healing. For people who doesn't eat enough protein, when you have a wound, it's not easy to heal and then it's going to develop scar. Have you ever seen people who have like they have a wound and then their BCG especially, they can grow, become very big, like keloid, reddish kind of scar, is because there are not enough nutrients to repair that wound.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. And also protein helps in energy production. That's why protein is so important. Okay. So and good fats. Fats is actually the essential structure of our cells. You know, like every cell, there's one layer of fats around our cell. That's the membrane. Okay. So if this membrane is not good, okay, means your cell is going to die easily, right? So that's why it's caused a lot of problems as well. So it helps to keep your brain and nerves. Our brain and nerves are basically 60% of them are made from fats as well. Okay, and keep your cells hydrated because if your membrane is strong, all the water inside your cell can be kept inside rather than like evaporated. So that's why you would see that like people who have eczema problem, dry skin, dry eye, whenever they take in sufficient good fats, it's going to improve their condition so much better. Okay. So, and fats also helps in hormones and vitamin D production. Okay. For the sexual hormones is made from fats. That's very important. Okay. And also helps in absorption of fat soluble vitamins, vitamin A, D, E, and K. So protect our organs. You know, sometimes when we jump around, do your organs fall here and there? it doesn't happen, right? It's because you have the fat that's supporting it. So for especially for elderly people, when they do not get enough fats and do not get enough protein as well, you will start to see that when, you know, when they are sitting in a car and they go through the bump, they feel like, oh, very discomfort because all the things are jumping around in the body, you know. Okay, that's
loose.
So yeah, exactly. So it's like that. So it's fats is like a cushion to protect all the organs, okay, and also energy storage. Whatever we eat extra will become our storage. Then it helps in keeping cholesterol, blood pressure under control, because especially omega-3. Omega-3 is really proven that it's going to help in lowering your cholesterol, helps in the blood circulation, helps in your heart, protecting your heart, things like that, right?
Yeah. Okay, so but that's not only that, actually, omega-3, last time we have read that, it will determine the tendency of a baby's sex, you know? So let's say, for example, maybe it's a baby boy. If the mother lack of omega-3, the tendency of the boy might be a bit towards female type of tendency, you know, which is what we read of. So it's very dangerous. So pregnancy mama should have more omega-3 actually.
Yes, correct. Exactly. So then comes to dietary fiber. So it's not just for gut health only, it's not just helping in your bowel movement, constipation, bloating, things like that. So it also helps in keeping you feeling full longer, also helps in sugar and fats level in the body. It's very, very important on that. Okay, and also helps in weight loss. Okay, so make sure you really eat enough dietary fiber, and at the same time, all these fiber are the food for the friendly bacteria in our stomach. So we feed the right bacteria, the good bacteria, rather than the bad bacteria, so that they can help to protect the whole gut lining. And recent research has shown that this bacteria, not just for gut, they are not just beneficial for gut, they are also very important for our immune system, for our mentality, for our positivity, our sleep as well. Okay, so that's why it's very important to have dietary fiber, enough dietary fiber, okay, in your diet. So then the next one is carbohydrates. It's the main source of energy. So basically, we cannot live without carbohydrates. We definitely will need certain amount of carbs. Okay, so because it helps to power up our whole body, and glucose is the main power source of brain. Okay, so that's why we develop like cravings towards sugar. It's because the brain loves it. Okay, it likes the energy. Okay, so and also, for children, it helps in their rapid growth. If they are not eating enough carbohydrates, they don't have enough energy to grow to reach to their own potential. Okay. So of course, excess carbs will be stored as fat. So that's very important. About carbohydrates, it's not about eating, it's more about the quality of the carbohydrates that you need. Okay. So that's more important because in the market, a lot of people talk about, hey, I need to cut carbs, I need to cut carbs to lose weight, for health, things like that. But it's about the quality of carbs that you are taking that's more important, okay? Yep. So complex carbs is the one that comes with a lot of nutrients, okay? So that's why at nutrients, including like vitamins and also fibers, that gives us the energy and also add other vitamins at the same time, rather than refined carbohydrates, which contain only sugar inside. The refined carbs, that is the one that's going to cause a lot of health problems in our body. Yeah.
Yep. Okay. After that, we will have micronutrients. Micronutrients mean that you don't need a lot, but you need it. So let's say, for example, like vitamin B complex. So in B complex, it will contain B1, B2, B6, B12. So why we need that? Because vitamin B actually is is the energy production. Why energy production? It doesn't produce energy by itself, but it will convert the food into the energy. That's why you need all these B to group together to function. And also our nerve function, you want your nerve function well, so you need B complex into your diet as well. And the other one is vitamin E. For example, vitamin E actually is a kind of antioxidant. So antioxidant means anti-aging, and then the same time it's also anti-cancer. Then the same time, if vitamin E, those people have enough vitamin E, the fertility's ability actually is higher. So you can see nowadays a lot of people infertile, probably they are lack of vitamin E as well. So they can supplement themselves with vitamin E. But vitamin E, because it's an oil-soluble vitamin, so it's not so easy to absorb. So you must take it together with some oily food. Okay, so for next will be the mineral, the multi-mineral. So we need different kind of mineral as well, not only calcium. Calcium in kind is kind of mineral, but let's say like copper. Copper is good for the cardiovascular and nervous system. So we need that also, because why? So in order for your body, your kidney and your heart to work well, actually they need this. They need the copper to transmit the signal so that they know which to do, which to coordinate themselves among themselves so that they can work well. Because the kidney and the heart actually working in a way that they complement each other, I should say that. Okay, the other one is chromium. So chromium is a kind of a mineral actually helping to regulate our glucose level. So the chromium will actually promote our sensitivity in our pancreas so that our pancreas can produce the insulin to regulate the sugar level in your blood, and also and help in protein and fat metabolism. Okay, so next will be the phytonutrients. Nowadays, don't you think that the sun is getting hotter and hotter because of this global warming? Then do you find out that we are always staying indoor, but all the plants outdoor, they stay under the sun maybe from 9 or 10 o'clock in the morning, then start getting hotter and hotter until late evening, but then they never get burned. Why? Because they have this phytonutrient to protect them. Well, this phytonutrient is good to protect them from free radical damage. This free radical actually come from all the UV, all the pollutant in the air. So it will protect. So once you take this phytonutrient into your body, actually this phytonutrient can protect you from damage by the free radical. So this free radical actually is in the whole big environment, which you can't avoid because it will come to your body through maybe UV or maybe inhale from the air that you inhale.
Sometimes
it's
from our food as well.
Our food
processed
and our water
food, chemicals
well.
In our food. And
correct.
Also when we exercise, we also generate free radicals food. In our body as well. So
correct.
That's why it's very important to protect ourselves, because free radicals just damage ourselves just like that. Our cell will die even earlier. So that's why it's related to aging, premature aging as well. So that's the importance of phytonutrients.
Correct. Your cell will get oxidized. Then the oxidation is also a free radical damage as well. Okay.
So why supplements is important nowadays? Because some people will say, hey, my parents' time, my grandparents' time, they never take supplements. They are there, but they are so healthy, they can live until 90 years old. Okay.
Yes.
I just want to say one thing is that our lifestyle nowadays is totally different from theirs. Okay. So our nowadays, we live with phones, we live with gadgets, we live with a lot of processed food, a lot of colorings, chemicals, pollutants, and even stress and fast-paced kind of lifestyle. So it's like it's very hard for us to totally go back to their kind of lifestyle already. So this is our lifestyle, and this kind of lifestyle causes our body to drain off nutrients even faster. That's why nowadays, even though our medical is getting more and more advanced, but more and more people are getting sick, right? So that's why what is happening is because the nutrition part, we are not doing so well on it. So that's why supplementation becomes more and more important in our lifestyle. So so how do we, like just now we talked about, there are so many types of nutritions, and how do we actually make sure that we get all of them every day in the most simplest and convenient way? So that's why we have POWER10 breakfast for you. So this video is about 4 minutes, so you all can watch it with excitement, because inside the video is me. So and then why do we use that light bulb? Okay, that light bulb actually represents like energy level. So whenever we connect the cable into the liquids, there are four cups in the picture you can see. So liquids, the four cups represent different types of breakfast. So when we put the cable into each and different every breakfast, you will see whether the light bulb will turn on or not. Because if the light bulb can turn on, meaning that in that kind of breakfast, there are a lot of electrolytes and nutrients inside the breakfast that's able to provide our body with a lot of energy. Okay, so enjoy the video.
Hello, 大家好，今天我将要教大家如何在两分钟里面准备一家大小的营养餐。OK, 首先我们来看一下材料有什么。第一是水果，然后接下来我们有牛奶，喜欢喝水，或者是你要放那些豆奶，任何的那些 almond milk 都可以。接下来是有一些营养素，第一个是 daily, 是毛际维生素提供所有我们需要的 vitamins and minerals, vitamin B 帮助我们消化提高能量， vitamin C 帮助我们提高免疫力消炎解毒， lecithin E 这个是帮助我们胆固醇的那个 level, 然后也是帮助我们抗氧化，然后最后一个是 calcium magnesium, 是帮助我们的骨骼，然后让我们放松，更加容易睡觉。如果是否有一些健康问题的话，我们会再添加其他的营养素，例如好像 milk T cell 保护我们的肝脏，然后有银杏人参帮助血液循环，帮助我们的脑部的那个记忆力，然后我们还有这个营养包，这个你只要吃一包，就相当于你吃完20多种的营养素。这个营养包它有三种口味，第一种是 berry, 有咖啡，还有巧克力，帮助你调那个味道，所以你可以每一天都可以做出五花八门不同的口味 for 你的全家人。然后最重要的还我们有这个蛋白粉，帮助我们修复身体每一个部位，然后帮助小孩子的成长，这都是很重要的一个营养素啦。然后我们就放牛奶。OK, 水果打烂了是可以了，然后把那些营养素倒进去，打碎为止。然后还有我们的蛋白粉，可以跟着你要做给多少个人的分量加进去，一个人就一个汤匙。OK, 然后你可以倒冰， okay? 然后你可以放任何你喜欢的东西，好像你要放 oats, 放 chia seed, 放 nuts, 之类的都可以。所以现在我们来做一个实验给大家看，看一下我们平时所吃的东西可是不是有足够的营养。 OK, 这里有四种不同的人，第一种人呢，他是不吃早餐的，只是喝清水然后就去上班了的。第二种人呢，他是吃一些nasi lemak啊、roti canai啊、炒米粉啊、果条汤这类的。 OK, 这个是一个薯粉，所以就代表着他们所吃的食物。 OK, 所以有些人呢，他会吃一些营养，那些还会吃一些蛋白粉。 OK, 这是 protein, 放一点点下去。最后一种人呢，他就会喝刚才我们所打了两分钟的营养餐。OK, 所以我们就看一下有什么分别。OK, 我用这个灯泡来为大家做那个示范。OK, 所以为什么用灯泡呢？因为灯泡当我们身体有足够能量的时候，灯泡就会亮。OK, 所以它越亮的时候，就代表我们所吃的食物有越多的营养。OK, 所以这灯泡是真的是可以 work 的，我放在汤匙给你们看一下。OK, 是这样子的。OK, so for 喝水的人，只是喝清水的人，你觉得他们营养够吗？很明显营养是不会不够的。OK, 灯泡完全没有亮。那么吃那些淀粉，吃那些nasi lemak那些人呢？ OK, 也是没有营养的。OK, 灯泡也是完全没有亮。也是很多人吃了那些这些淀粉类很高的食物过后，他们都会想要睡觉的。喝 protein 的人呢？有一点点的能量，看得到吗？有一点点的营养。OK, 因为只是 protein 罢了，营养不够完整。OK,来 ，so 我们的那个两分钟营养餐是怎样的呢？是完全亮到很厉害的那一种，代表它的营养完整，结构全部都很好。OK, so 吃了下去，你整一整天的那个精神都会有在的。OK, so for example, 今天你是一个完全都不吃早餐的人，或者吃的没有很营养早餐的人，所以你希望今天也可以改善 自己的健康，那你可以怎么样呢？没有关系，你可以从这个营养餐慢慢的开始调整 ，OK？ 当然需要一点时间，而且你喝一天 ，OK， 有一点点的，两天、三天、一个礼拜、两个礼拜，你的健康就慢慢慢慢的改善，你可以看到身体你会有越来越大的改变。如果你们有这样子的问题的话，这个营养餐肯定可以帮到你。
Okay, so why the light bulb will light up? Because inside the blend have a lot of nutrients and mineral and also protein, so that it can help to, the electrolyte in our body to work well. So that's why it can transmit in electrical. And also our body is need to transmit signal as well. So when you're talking, when you use your brain to give a signal to your hand, to your talking, to your speech, everything you need a signal, all the signal will transmit through the vitamin and mineral inside the blend as well. So you can see, you can use up the energy, you can use up the nutrient immediately to convert into energy. And also, because when we digest our food, we need energy to digest the food as well. But if you already have the blender to work for you, your body will consume less energy to digest the food, but instead they will use the energy to do something else. So you can see how powerful is this POWER10 blend. Okay.
Yeah, that's why it's very suitable, not just for healthy people. It's also very suitable for people who are sick, who has very poor digestive issue. So it actually can help them to ensure they get all the nutrients they need without compromise. That's very important. Yeah.
Yeah, true. Inside here, we also emphasize the milk teaser, because the milk teaser is very important for those people who have need to protect the liver function. It doesn't mean that only people have a liver issue, they only have to take this. But basically, most of the people also have a slightly liver issue, because why? Most of the people now will sleep late, like to take some fried food. Also, okay, and also some people may take some medication. They will cause damage to our liver as well. That's why we need the milk teaser to protect our liver and to expel the toxin from our liver. Then the next one will be the Siberian ginseng and jingo. This will promote the body, the blood circulation. So in the long run, you will feel that your memory actually is getting better. Because for me, because of my, since young, I used to have sinus issue. So my nose are always blocked, either left or right blocking. So I can find that actually my memory actually also affected as well during my very young time. Even though I go out, so sometimes I come back, I also forget something. So my friend sometimes tease me, hey, 你不要等一下出去，改天你结婚以后你出去啊，你把你的孩子带出去以后，你忘了带回来。 So this is what my friend tested me. So this is, you can see how forgetful am I. But after I taking this blend already, I feel that my memory actually improved a lot also, so that I'm not that forgetful already, because the blood circulation getting better, especially women used to have a very cool hand and feet. So after taking this Siberian ginseng and jingo, actually we can feel it warmer because the blood circulation getting better already. Okay, next.
Exactly. So like just now we show, hey, there are so many supplements, will I get overdose? One of the things I want to explain to you all is the concept of RDA, AI, and UL. RDA is the recommended daily allowance, means the minimum required amount needed for a healthy person, means to ensure that if you get RDA for all the nutrients, means you have a balanced diet. Okay, so that's very minimum. Means if below that, then you will have deficiency, then you will have like, for example, if vitamin C, if you eat lesser than that, then you get gum bleeding easily, scurvy. Yeah, right. So for AI, it's adequate intake. It's the amount required to maintain adequate nutritional state, means optimal health. Because adequate intake is varies among individuals depending on their lifestyle and diet. Okay. And upper limit is the maximum daily amount that is unlikely to cause any health issue. Okay, means that, for example, if vitamin C is 2,000 milligrams, so then if you eat, if you take within 2,000 mg, that's still okay. There's nothing going to happen to you. But if you take 2,001, then maybe something will happen to you already. Okay, so that's the idea. So because if for today, If you, there are people who say, hey, I actually take good care of my diet, I eat, make sure I eat all the nutrients already, I have balanced diet, but how come I still end up in hospital with a stroke? Okay, so it's very, very funny, right? So you see some people eat very healthy, but then they are still getting stroke. It's because they are not getting the AI that's needed for their body. Okay, that's very important, because if you're not getting AI, means you're constantly draining a lot of nutrients for your body as well. Okay, I'm just going to show you an example. Okay, so for example, RDA for vitamin C is 90 milligram a day. Okay, so if you are a smoker, the cigarettes will drain the vitamin C faster. Okay, one stick will drain 50 mg of vitamin C. Okay, so if someone who smoked 10 sticks of cigarettes a day, so this is how the calculation is. You need to, the RDA, 90 milligram, plus 10 sticks of the cigarettes, which is 50 mg times 10. So total in a day, you need 590 milligram of vitamin C. Okay, so then you know if this is the amount to make sure that you are not going to get poor immunity or lung issue, things like that. Okay, so and for this amount is because different lifestyle, they would use different amount of vitamins. So for this 590 mg is for smoker without any stress, without eating out, without exposing to environmental pollution, and not using phone. Okay, so if today you are a smoker and then you have high stress, you always eat out, drink alcohol, and then you use phones, laptops very often, then definitely your dosage will be more than 590 mg. Okay, so and upper limit for vitamin C 2000 mg. So in order to reach to get optimal health, you need to consume 590 to 2000, that range. Okay, so this is an idea for you. So and you can see that this is a research that if today we are really taking good care of our diet alone, we are still having a very big gap, a very shortfall in our nutrients level. Okay, so for example, if you're having a good diet already, your vitamin C, you are probably getting 200 mg of vitamin C a day, but then it may not be even sufficient for your body. Like if you're a smoker who smoke 10 cigarettes a day, you need 590. So the 300 mg gap, how are you going to fulfill? Then this is where supplements will come into it. Okay, right. So that's why POWER10 is very, very helpful, is because in 2 minutes, it provides everything that our body needs for the whole family, okay, to make sure that whatever issue that you have in your body currently is able to start doing the repairing work. That's why it can like help you to improve your digestion, improve your immune system, improve on liver health, like balancing all your hormones, things like that, cardiovascular issue as well. So that there are actually a lot of benefits that even me, Lisa, and a lot of people around us has experienced the benefit of this POWER10. And in fact, this breakfast has helped millions of people around the world to get back their health. So that's why I would really suggest all of you to give it a try. If you really have no idea how to get a balanced diet for yourself and your family, this is the easiest way for you. Okay?
Yeah. I would like to add more on the AI and the UL, the upper limit and also the adequate intake. So for my example, myself, so last time during my sinus, that time, very serious sinus, because got inflammation inside already, all the phlegm inside is become turning yellowish towards brownish already. At that time, it's very high inflammation, then very congested in my nose. So I cannot breathe well. Also, I feel my throat, everything is congested and sore throat also. So that time, how I try to know what is my upper limit? So I start with maybe at that time when I start to consume Nutrilite product, which is already 11 years ago, the time when I try out how good is our Bio-C. So that time one tablet is 250 milligram. I start to take two first. When I take two, I feel like no feeling at all. Okay, so next time, that means lunchtime, I'll start to take five already, which is around 1,250 already. So one is 250, five mean 1,250 milligram already. Then I start to feel slightly improved a little bit. So the next round, I'll start to take 10, which is 2,005. And when I take 2,005, I start to feel like, I already have the cooling sensation, means the inflammation in my throat and my nose start to cool down already. Then I know, that is my dose ready. So one day in the morning, I start with 2,500. And then in the afternoon, I take another 2,500. And then at night, I take another 2,500. That means one day I take 7,500, which I can immediately feel my whole body is start cooling down and not much congested. Then my phlegm actually start from very heavy, brownish color, become yellowish, and light yellow, become greenish, white, and stop the whole running nose, everything. No phlegm anymore. Then I know my upper limit actually is 7,500. So now every day, I at least need 2,000. So day and night, morning and nighttime, I take 1,000 and 1,000. So I will break. Actually, I will break the vitamin C, the bio C before I swallow. So I know that every day I need 2,000. So when I get sick already, I know I start to feel not so feeling well already. I start to take maybe three tablets, which is 1,500. Then I break everything. If I still don't feel better, I start to increase to five already the next round. So it's about 2,005. Then I get better already. So then I will take for a few time a day, maybe two times or three times a day, or for 2-3 days, then I get better. If I'm not getting better, then I know my upper limit is 7,500. I start to take that limit already. So this is my upper limit. So individually, you will have your own upper limit, because why? Your stress level might be different from me. Maybe the way you use your electronic devices, your environment, your diet is different from me. So you have to try. You have to test your own upper limit. You have to try slowly, then you know what is your upper limit. This is my sharing on how I get to know my upper limit lah. Okay?
So, generally, like upper limit, like for example, vitamin C is like 2,000 mg. So of course, like in cases, like emergency cases, like what Lisa mentioned, it's like you start to fall sick, start to have sore throat, or even you are like this whole week is like totally you did not sleep at all, things like that. So it that's why you can increase your dosage to more than 2,000 mg a day. It's because you are in an emergency need for that. So probably just for one whole week, you are taking like 4,000 mg, 7,500 a day. That's for that purpose. Then after that, when you are back to normal, your original life, then go back to your AI. Okay.
Yes.
Right.
Okay.
So
next.
Sharing by Lisa.
Yes. So this is my elder girl. So the time when she's about baby time, about 5 years, 5 months old, 5 months old, she got this rectal prolapse. What is that? In Chinese, we call tuo gang. Tuo gang means when you pull that time, the muscle in your rectum. Actually came out. So you can see from outside also. That's called tuo gang. Why Chinese say you got tuo gang? Because your body energy actually low already. You are very shiro. That's why you have this
weak
rectum, because the rectum actually the muscles get loosened already. Because she always gets sick. I used to give her a lot of this antibiotic, because that time I didn't learn about nutrition. So I also don't know how to take care of myself and also my kids. So at that time, when I pregnant that time, also very difficult, my pregnancy, the whole duration is very, very suffering also. I always get sick also. Then my baby also get very sick also when she become baby, when she come out. So she also developed asthmatic after this pneumonia. She got pneumonia about 3 years old that time. Because 2003, she born. And then actually, I think 2006 is the haze start to come to Malaysia. And then she has this pneumonia in 2007 when she's about 4 years old. So the time we start to give her two types of antibiotic. Okay, her pneumonia cure already, but she start to be all asthmatic already. Then she need to use the medication, the puffing one. So
inhaler.
And she, inhaler, yes. She need to, she and also she a very poor appetite also and low energy. So when I start this power 10, she, that time she already 7 years old. You can see it will take time. The left one, she's 13 years old. That time, her texture still not very good, but at least she's not getting sick so frequently already. And then the right-hand side, she is 15 years old. Yeah, she's 15 years old. You can see her skin color start to change already. And then her hair, before that, her hair is very thin and then start to build a very good hair. Then the hair, you can see more smooth because she has a lot of protein. So you can see how Power 10 helped her also. And now she's so healthy and then touch wood for the past 11 years, she never take any medication.
Yeah, she's even doing K-pop now.
Yes, yes. If you follow her in her Instagram, actually she's very active in dancing K-pop. Okay, the next sharing will be my my brother. My brother is the right-hand side one. He used to have insomnia. So he need to go to see the psychiatrist to take this sleeping pill, only able to sleep. But when taking sleeping pill, actually he couldn't sleep well also because sleeping pill actually forcing him to like pensan only, fainted only, but never sleep well. Because why? There's one night, my sister-in-law actually wake up just because someone beat her. So she was so shocked, why like that? Then she don't care, like, maybe she dream, she thought. But the second time, not the other day, like, another day, also again like this, you know. So she start to wake my brother up. She go and pa 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 water.
Slap him. Brother.
Slap my brother. And then wake him up. He said, hey, 你为什么打我? Then my brother said, no. I never beat anybody, but I dream of I beat someone. I'm fighting with someone. Maybe because of that, he's like fighting and then go and hit my sister-in-law. So you can see a sleeping pill actually not getting you a good sleep, but in fact, they just make you faint only. So he couldn't sleep well. That's why energy is very low. So he need to take some sugary drinks to boost his energy. And then when the time he start to build some unknown diseases, he only feel that not very comfortable that time. So my father start to take this blood pressure for him, but his blood pressure is still low. So my mom told me, then I start to call him and say, hey, don't joke, you know, got people 30 over years old get stroke, you know, because my cousin get stroke, said 37 years old. That time, same age as me, my cousin get stroke. So I tell him, you don't joke, you know, you don't play it lightly. Yeah, don't play, don't take it lightly because your kid is still very young, you know. Then I recommend him to start to take Power 10. After taking Power 10 for almost like 1 or 2 months really, when I have time to go back hometown, I start asking him, I say, hey, how is it after you taking the Power 10? He said, very good. I have very good sleep. Even though 2 or 3 alarm clock cannot wake me up. You can see how bad those days he cannot rest well. So he can now he can really rest well and then the body start to repair already. Because of that, confident in Power 10, actually he start to recommend the Power 10 to his staff. Because his staff, the left-hand side, the Malay, have high blood pressure, high cholesterol, and very the kidney function are also dropping really. So that's why my brother also so worried about him. Then my brother start recommending him. He said, hey, why not you take this blend? Because my father actually used to give him the blend as well, but he take it lightly. He also sometimes go and drink. My father offer him free, you know. Sometimes he go and drink, sometimes never go and drink. So now my brother tell him, okay, you buy one set, you keep at my mom's side, my mom will get the maid to blend for you, and then I slowly deduct the cost from your salary. Then he said, okay, because he saw his blood test report, he's so scared already because that blood test report showing that his kidney function dropping. So he start to take this month. Actually, after 3 months, actually, first week, he already feel the difference already. He start to go to the toilet very frequently because he has water retention. That's why he look very fat, but not really fat, but actually it's the water retention in the body. So he even couldn't knee or squat down. because of the all the skin is so tense already, because the water retained inside is expanded the skin. The skin can't bend, the knee can't bend, it's not. So after taking the power 10, they start to go to toilet more frequent because need to expel out all the water in the body. And then he also feel that he can sleep better and he can walk faster already. Then his energy is back there again. So he's so tekun, so rajin to come and drink the blend every day already. Okay. So next will be sharing from Chihua.
This is me. I believe a lot of you saw this photo today, right? So I used to be...
Look like different people.
Yeah. I used to be very, very underweight. My weight was like 39 kg to 40 kg that time. So a lot of time people would tell me, hey, you have to be careful when the wind blows. Okay, remember to grab on something that is strong. Okay. So that to me is like very bad. So I mean, at that time I don't even really know how to get my weight up. Okay. So and then that time I got a lot of pimples, I got a lot of scarring. So the pimples, I have no idea how to solve it, because today it grow here, tomorrow it grow here. The next day, it grow another place again, and it just ended up. The whole cheek area is like pimple and scar. So and then that's I have very low energy. So my housemate, they all know that this girl have to sleep at 10 p.m. every day. Okay, so if they see me like not sleeping after 10, they will say, "Hey, your timing already reached. Faster go and sleep." Right, so this they remember me that way, and I easily fall sick. And once I fall sick, I take almost 1 month to recover fully. Okay, That's a very important thing. So, I mean, usually people take 7 days. Okay, I take 1 month. That's very, very bad of my immune system. So, and then dry hair, that one is noticed by my friend after seeing this photo. I actually don't even know. So, I have a very painful menses. This one is like was once my phobia. Whenever I have my period, okay, I cannot walk. I have to sit on the floor. So I've been sitting on different kind of floor. I sit on my uni floor. I sit on my lab floor. I sit around the corridor. I couldn't. I really couldn't. It's really super painful. And then I need to vomit, definitely. Then I will have a lot of diarrhea, back pain, and then yeah, it's just like nightmare to me. Like every month I have to experience something like this. It's like, cannot, like, I don't know how to solve it.
Wish that
all.
You are male.
Yeah, exactly. And then it's very hard for me to fall asleep that time. So every, you know, because of this issue, I actually developed a lot of methods to fall asleep. I count sheep. I sing lullaby to myself. I a lot of things, even combining lullaby and counting sheep, a lot of method, but it's still not a very, very good sleep. And every time I wake up, I still can feel the tiredness in me. So, but then I started POWER10 for just one single reason. I want to gain back my weight, only for just that one reason. But then after trying for like few months time, I discovered that all this issue actually solved by itself. You know, so to me, it's like, oh, really a surprise. Hey, how come I just want to increase my weight, but then I ended up like solving everything for myself. Yeah. So that's very, very, I just want to say it's really very helpful in my health. And I believe it will definitely work for all of you as well.
Right? Yeah. Mm.
So for health, like, you know, like money and health, what is more important? So like even today, you have one million of in your bank account. But then if you are healthy, of course you can enjoy every cent of your money and even grow it even more to 2 million, 3 million, right? But if you are not healthy, you don't have the energy, you don't have the luxury to enjoy all of these things, right? The money, the car, the houses, the your family may not be like, because you are falling sick, and I find that it's a really kind of burden to them, things like that. So, and all other materials, all everything that you want, even your friends, your social life, everything couldn't be done just because you are sick. Okay, yeah. So you're losing very, very a lot, not just your own physical, but also your quality of life as well. So that's why it's so important that you have your health, invest in your health. So because health definitely will need a certain amount of investment. If today you are not investing, then in the future, definitely you need to invest on back on your health, on the medical bills again.
Right? Correct. Mm. So Americans used to invest every month, invest a little bit in their health. So instead of like Chinese, they used to save a lot. End of the day, they invest a lot in their health. End of the day in the hospital. So which one is more worth it? So I would prefer I invest now so that I can enjoy better. The meanwhile, I can earn more and enjoy more as well. So
yeah,
you choose which one. Okay,
yeah.
Now you have the answer.
You know, if you are not investing now, definitely in the future, you will pay so much more than that.
Yes. Okay. That one is not invest already. That one is expenses.
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah. So, these are the Power 10 packages. Mm. So, and also for people who are super really busy, always traveling and always on the go, then you can opt for like Secret Weapon X. So, these two sets, basically, it can provide you with a full nutrition in less than 20 ringgit a day. So, yeah. So, make your choices today. I believe definitely you all will benefit from it. I think it's almost time also.
Yes. Okay.
So, do you have any question?
Okay.
And also, remember to join our fitness WhatsApp group for further updates as well. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Our upcoming, every Tuesday, we will have our health sessions as well. So you can get more knowledge, get more information so that you can help yourself and also people around you better in their health. Right?
Yep.
Okay. So if there's no question, thank you for your time today.
Yes.
Thank you so much. So we pass back to MC.
Thanks.
All right. Thanks, Eva and Lisa.